Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this segment or this course, I want to talk about the sacrament of reconciliation. Of course, this topic, a lot of people ask questions to me. They ask questions like this: Father, why do we need to confess our sins? What is the scripture tells us about the sacrament of reconciliation? Why we have to go to the priest to confess our sins? Do you think priests have authority to forgive our sins? Why we just confess our sins direct to God? Of course, to answer these questions, I want to read the scripture from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 23. Let us begin with sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. A reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 23. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he shows them his hands and his side. Disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgiven are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Scripture. Let us see the context of the scripture of the Gospel of John, chapter 20, verses 19 to 23. Of course, this scripture's context, it was happened after Easter, before Jesus ascended into heaven. Jesus came to his disciples in the first week after the resurrection of Christ from the dead. As we read the scripture, we know the situation was intense because the leader of the Jews tried to spread that Jesus was not raised from the dead. They tried to convince to the people so that they can believe that Jesus not rose from the dead. His body was stolen by somebody and hid somewhere. You can imagine that it was so intense situations. Therefore, all disciples of Christ, they just stay inside the house and lock the door. In the midst of that situation, thanks be to God, Jesus showed up to them and tell them, "Peace be with you." And when they heard that peace from Christ, first they confused. And the second, Jesus come back and said to them, "Peace be with you." And after that, Jesus showed his hands and his side. The purpose is to convince his disciples, to give disciples a proof that Jesus came to them. When they saw and heard what Jesus said, they all overjoyed because they met with Jesus. When Jesus came the second time, Jesus again tell them, "Peace be with you." And after that, Jesus tell them, "As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Or in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18, verses 18 said, "Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." And then Jesus left them and lifted up into heaven. My brothers and sisters in Christ, in this scripture is very clear that the commission to forgive the sins of the people came from the God the Father to Jesus Christ. And then Jesus Christ gave the same commission to his apostles. In the scripture, very clear, tell us, "As the Father sent me, so I also send you." It's really important that after Jesus received the commission to forgive the sins of the people, and Jesus transferred that commission to his apostles. But remember that his apostle cannot do their own power without the authority of the Holy Spirit, because Jesus gave this commission after he breathed on them the Spirit of God. That's why, my brothers and sisters, the priests in here, they just a tool of God to hear your sins, and the power to forgive your sins is God himself. Let us go back the question. Do you think priest has authority to forgive the sins of the people? The answer is that only God has authority to forgive the sins of the people. But the priest, as a secondary person who has authority by Christ himself, through the Holy Spirit, to hear your sins and give the commission to give you penance and absolution. In the scripture, especially in the book of Leviticus, chapter 19, verses 21 to 20 said, "The man moreover shall bring to the entrance of the meeting 10 rams as his guilt offering to the Lord. With this ram, the priest shall make atonement before the Lord for sins he has committed, and it will be forgiven." In this context, that God himself has authority to forgive our sins, the priest has authority in the name of Christ to hear your sins, to give you penance and absolution once again in the name of Christ himself. Like St. Paul tell us in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 18 says, "And all this is from God, who has reconciled us to himself through Christ and given us the ministry of reconciliation." Therefore, the priest in this context, he just hear your sins, and he has authority and power to give you penance and absolutions in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of God. What does that mean in here? That the priest cannot do anything about something to you except God himself. He is just only a tool of God himself. He just listen your sins. He just hear your sins. He cannot share your sins to somebody else. It is a very confidential matter. That's why in here, my brothers and sisters, that the priest only a tool from God to hear your sins, give you penance and absolutions in the name of Christ himself. In 2 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 10 says, "Whomever you forgive anything, so I do so. For indeed, what I have forgiven, if I have forgiven anything, has been for you in the presence of Christ." It is a really important message to tell us that Jesus gave the apostle commission to forgive the sins in the name of himself. It means that a priest only a tool to hear your sins and has authority to give you penance and absolution. It's really important, therefore, that when you come to confess your sins, remember, you come to God to confess your sins, not to the priest. A priest as a person who just sitting there, hear your sins and give you penance and absolution in the name of Christ himself. Therefore, don't be misunderstanding in this context, because so many people said that, well, I don't like to go to confess because I go to confess my sins to the priest. Might be the priest want to share my sins to other people. Might be the priest want to judge me whatever he wants to judge me. Remember, I tell you, the priest is only the person to hear your sins, to give you penance and also absolution. The priest cannot share your sins to somebody. It is confidential matter. That's why I encourage you as the Catholic people, that when you come to confess your sins, remember, you come to God to confess your sins. A priest, only representative of God himself, who's sitting there and hear your sins, give you penance and absolution. Thank you so much for watching this video. May God bless you and may always be with you now and forever. Thank you.